bottled, purified, or tap water. There are even companies selling GMO-free water. But is all water really the same? Okay, first things first. Almost 4 billion years ago, the first living organisms appeared in the ocean.
What's up?
And today, whether you're a microscopic bacterium, a giant redwood, or a human being, we all need water. It is literally the stuff of life. About 2/3 of our bodies are water. Without it, we don't exist. But it's pretty amazing to think that the water in this cup has literally been traveling around for billions of years. Cretaceous period. Now, you may have noticed that not all water tastes the same. So what accounts for having so many different flavor profiles? Water isn't just H2O. It's a cocktail of minerals and compounds it picks up along the journey through rivers and pipes before landing in your glass.
Nice.
For example, water that has a slight milky taste might indicate calcium. Or sodium leads to a kind of salty quality. Meanwhile, magnesium adds a hint of bitterness. Sulfur-producing microbes in groundwater can add a sulfur kind of scent to tap water near the beach. While well water passes through limestone underground, and that can give it a chalky taste. Even the season can make a detectable difference in the water we drink. For example, algal blooms. When they occur, they can release a smelly chemical called geosmin into water, and that can have a muddy smell. It won't harm you, but water treatment doesn't remove it either. And temperature can affect the taste of water too. If it's very cold, the flavor might seem to disappear. Now, when I was growing up in New York, my grandparents used to tell me,
Cheryl, we have the best water in the world, and that's why we have the best bagels. Now eat something.
So what makes the Big Apple's water so special? It's piped in from a reservoir in the mountains of upstate New York, which has lower concentrations of calcium and magnesium. Now, let's touch on distilled water. Or it's probably fair to say, boring water. Water gets distilled to remove virtually all of those aforementioned soluble compounds that have dissolved in it. And that's the reason we tend to use distilled water in certain appliances. The lack of extra minerals is good, say, for steam irons, but not that interesting for our taste buds. Distilled water tastes like nothing. But wait. Should we all be drinking distilled water to avoid added compounds? No. Those taste enhancers, can we call them taste enhancers? They're not bad for us. They just make the experience of drinking water a little more interesting. I like to think of them like each water droplet's travel journal. Water treatment plants are responsible for making sure the water we get is safe. Sometimes they do add disinfectants like chlorine, and that can also affect the taste at the other end of the tap. The pipes that transport water matter too. Old pipes can leach iron into the water, giving it a metallic taste. Iron is actually okay, but high iron levels in water might also indicate the presence of lead, which isn't good. Now, shifting gears, let's explore another aspect of water that impacts its characteristics, its mineral composition. You've probably heard water described as hard or soft. When water has an excess of dissolved calcium and magnesium, we call it hard. Hard water can make plants' natural pectin more firm when we're cooking up fruits and veggies. Not ideal, but a little table salt can counteract this problem. It's also one reason you might see spots on your glasses and dishes after washing. Soft water, on the other hand, has lower concentrations of calcium and magnesium. But if they're too low, and we're cooking up some, say, bagels in the kitchen, the gluten molecules don't link very well, so bakers might get frustrated with water that's too soft. As for water itself, it can be easy to take for granted in parts of the world where it's readily available. We simply expect it to be there when we get thirsty, when we turn on the faucet, boil an egg, or take a shower. But in many places, water isn't always accessible, and it's our most critical resource. Unfortunately, climate change is going to make many of those regions drier, more arid, and unpredictable over time. And that can have tremendous repercussions on the global food system. So what I hope you remember is that regardless of whether it's earthy, salty, or chalky, water will continue to be vitally important to global health and our future. But what can we do to make sure there's enough clean, fresh water to go around? I'm glad you asked. Okay, I asked, but I can also offer some ideas. We can limit the chemicals we put down our drains, like fertilizers and pesticides that pollute lakes and oceans. We can work together in our communities to protect and restore wetlands like swamps and riverbanks. They clean water naturally while also providing habitats for wildlife. So the next time you take a sip of water, remember, it's not just a drink, it's a journey. From mountain springs to city taps, every drop has a story to tell. And hey, if nothing else, it's keeping us all hydrated. Now tell us, are you team tap, bottled, or boxed water? Drop your hydration hacks in the comments below.